I don't want to sound dramatic here, but doing well in your summer internship can really change the course of your entire career. And so today I'm going to be sharing you 7 important tips so that you can crush your summer internship. What's up everyone, my name is Ben and welcome to Rare Liquid, a channel where I draw from my experience as a former JP Morgan investment banking analyst to create videos about career advice and tech investing. In case you are new to the channel, I create videos about tech investing on the weekdays and career advice on the weekends. And in case you're interested in looking into any specific topics, please feel free to check out my playlists on my channel where I categorize all the different videos that I make. The 7 tips I have for you today are based on my experience at JP Morgan, just seeing a bunch of interns get offers and a bunch who didn't. And I tried to create a list that you can't really find too easily elsewhere on the internet or whoever you ask. And so, you know, some of them might be things you might have heard of a little bit, but I'll try to provide my own unique little twist. And with that said, let's get started. Tip number 1 is to immediately figure out what your team is looking for. During your first 1 to 2 weeks of your internship, what you should be doing is setting up coffee chats or Zoom calls with every single member on your team. My own personal belief is that humans are the one that drive the entire business, right? It's not always just about what products companies sell or what services they offer. People at the end of the day are making all the decisions, and when you introduce yourself to your boss or your boss's boss, basically these people have, they might have decades of experience of just knowledge and information that they can provide you. And it's really important that during these initial conversations that you have with your team, that you try to draw from their experiences. As a result, in these initial conversations, what I highly, highly recommend is always leaving a little bit of time of just simply asking them, you know, if you were in my shoes as a summer intern here, what kind of things would you be looking for? And what are the best ways for me to really kind of stand out as a really, really great summer intern? Because I want to do the best job possible. First of all, this is important because it'll really show and give a good first impression that you're focused on doing well at your job. Second of all, I think people in general in the workforce, and especially if they have decades of experience, really actually enjoy giving advice to people who are younger because they may see a little bit of themselves in you, or of course they've been in your position at some point, and most likely your team is going to want you to succeed. Third, if you've amassed all this knowledge from, let's say, 5 to 10 different people on your team, then you basically have the foundation and the knowledge that you really need to kind of know what you need to do on the job, because all the information that these people have given you will be based on what they think that you'll need to do. And so you basically kind of have like a little bit of a cheat sheet basically of what you need to do. And now it's really just on you to execute. 2 additional smaller tips that I'd like to add is, first of all, I actually would not recommend taking down notes as you guys are having these conversations, because these should be a little bit more casual and you don't want to look like you're trying too hard. And so just keep mental notes down if the person you're talking to is saying anything interesting. Second, on the note of keeping things casual, I'd highly recommend not focusing the entire conversation on work advice or work-related topics. I'd highly, highly recommend focusing more on getting to know the person more on an individual basis. You know, ask them what their favorite movies are, books are, what they like to do outside of work, those kinds of things, because that'll really establish the relationship a lot more strongly. But I do recommend leaving a little bit of that time for figuring out or getting that advice of basically what you need to do well during your internship. By the way, if you're interested in a career in finance, I highly recommend checking out some of the courses on Financial Edge, whether you're interested in investment banking, accounting, or asset management. The founder, Alistar, is the instructor who taught me and hundreds of other analysts during my training at JP Morgan. And he's this British guy with a great personality who made it really fun to learn about finance during training. Financial Edge is a sponsor for this video, but I recommend them to anyone who's interested in finance because I think they offer the best courses. Their instructors train the analysts at the top 4 banks who pay thousands and thousands of dollars, and you can get the same lessons for just a few $100s and learn at your own pace, so I really think it's worth it. If you're interested, check out my link in the description below and use my code RareLiquid25 and you can get 25% off. Okay, now let's go to tip number 2, treat your internship like a sprint, not a marathon. The reason I use this language is because I actually believe that for a full-time job, you should treat your job as a marathon and not a sprint. But when it comes to your internship, because it's just such a short time period and you don't really have that much time to really prove yourself, you should actually be working really, really, really hard so you can secure that internship and either get that full-time job from the return offer or use that internship offer to leverage it for other opportunities. During my time at JP Morgan, I was a recruiting captain for 2 years, and so I came came across a lot of candidates during full-time recruiting where they didn't have return offers from other middle market banks or other banks that they worked at. And so it would really cause me to question them as a candidate, whether it's fair or not. You know, I would think if this other bank doesn't want them, then why should we really consider them? And so usually those candidates just simply did not get an interview because simply for that reason alone. In addition to this, let's say this is your junior summer internship and it can lead to a return offer which will give you full-time employment after college, then basically what you need to do is just work super, super hard for 8 to 10 weeks during your internship. And then for the rest of senior year, you don't have anything to worry about because you're gonna have that full-time job, right? So you get to work really, really hard for a few months in order to really enjoy yourself for the next 1+ years without many worries, right? And I think that's really, really worth it, which is hence why I say treat your internship as a sprint and not a marathon. A little bit more tangibly, a few things that you can do. The first one is just to be the first one in and the last one out. And I know that right now with COVID, things may be virtual, but eventually if you are going into the office, then that's what I would recommend. And even if you don't really have anything to do, just literally go through companies or your team's old materials, old presentations or old financial models, whatever you can find, and just spend time practicing and learning more. The second thing is to never, never miss a single day during your entire internship. And of course, if you're really, really sick and you really can't go, you're hospitalized or something, then of course, then take that time off. But besides that, you should really not be missing a single day during your internship. Third, I recommend trying to take on every single assignment that you can. Constantly, you should be asking your coworkers if there's any additional work that you can be doing or see if there's anything that you can take off their plate. And honestly, a lot of times you're gonna get a lot of no's and you don't wanna be too annoying where you're asking, you know, every single hour or something like that. But at least once a day, just check in with your coworkers and see if there's anything more you can do. So just to bring everything together, just mentally in your head when you're doing your internship, think of it as a sprint, not a marathon. Try to come home each day knowing that you put in your 100% effort and really, really did everything that you could to help everyone out at the office and learn as much as you can. Tip number three is to focus on quality and not on speed. Now, I know I just talked about sprints and marathons, but that focuses more on how hard you should be working and your mentality. This tip is more focused on the quality of your work. Now, this might be one of the most common mistakes that I've seen interns make, which is that they constantly focus on, I need to do things ASAP and work really, really quickly. And usually what this leads to is a lot of mistakes. And actually the entire process of me giving an assignment to an intern will take longer if there's much more back and forth versus if an intern really focuses on doing everything right during the first 1 to 2 times around. I'm sorry, but the really, really cold hard truth is that as an intern, you are a liability, not an asset. And basically, if I'm, you know, working on this big financial model or this big presentation, as an analyst who's been working there for 1 to 2 years myself, or just, you know, as someone who's experienced in no matter what field that you're in, you're gonna be able to do whatever assignment you need to work on, probably like honestly 5 to 10 times faster than any new summer intern. Especially if you're working with someone who's been at their job for a while, then they'll know that giving work to interns, you know, they know that they should be budgeting extra time for mistakes or for just you figuring out what you need to be doing and how to utilize all the resources within the company correctly. And so they'll budget that extra time for you to be able to get your work done. And what I really highly, highly recommend is that whenever you're given an assignment, write down everything that you need to do in a list. Once you finish whatever project or assignment that you're working on, go through that project and highlight every single thing on your list that you needed to do and just double, triple check that everything is done correctly. Over time, you're gonna be able to establish your reputation as a reliable intern and you'll be given some more important and interesting work, and eventually the speed will also come as well. Tip number four is to ask questions as strategically as you can. Contrary to the old saying that there is no such thing as a dumb question, there absolutely is, in my opinion. For example, if you're in a meeting with a client and your boss was there or something like that, and you ask, hey, is the sky blue today? Then obviously that's a dumb question. When it comes to work, in my opinion, dumb questions are simply ones that you can figure out yourself either by searching on Google or just, you know, watching a YouTube video or something like that. By the way, on the topic of YouTube videos, I'd really appreciate if you could like this video and subscribe if you haven't already to support the channel. I spend a ton of time working on these videos, and so I'd always just really appreciate that support. But anyway, going back to the topic of asking questions strategically, what I'd recommend is, first of all, if you're in a really big time crunch and you have to get something out the door ASAP, and you don't know how to do something, then you should for sure be asking those questions right away. But if you're not in that kind of situation and you're working on something that's a bit more of a longer term project or assignment, then what I personally recommend and what I used to do all the time is throughout the day while you're working, questions are gonna pop up naturally and just keep a list on your email as a draft or write them down on a notebook, whatever questions you have, and then try to ask your either fellow summer intern colleagues or other coworkers that you have that you're a little bit more closer and comfortable with, ask them those questions first. And then after basically you've tried your best to figure out everything that you can possibly on your own, that's when I would reach out to your boss or your supervisor and schedule a bit of time with them saying, hey, I've done as much as I could with this project. There are a few bit of a roadblocks with some questions that I have. Could I schedule 20-30 minutes to just go through these with you? A lot of the time, you don't even need to be as formal like that. You know, you could just literally, what I used to do is pop over to my associate's cubicle and say, hey, I have a list of questions. Can you just let me know when it works for you? And they'd say, yeah, sure, you can ask me right now. Or they'd say, yeah, can you just reach out again in 30 minutes? I'll be free then, or I'll come by your cubicle whenever I'm free, you know? And that's really the best way to really ask these questions strategically, in my opinion. Figure out everything that you can on your own, then create a list, ask as many people as you can that you feel comfortable with how to get these questions answered, and then go to your supervisor. Tip number 5 is to ask for feedback with each important milestone. Now, asking for feedback is a very, very common advice that's given to interns, and I would say that you'd actually be surprised how easy it is to forget to ask for feedback. Not all interns actually do it, and not all of them do them well. The first little nuance is that you don't want to actually be asking for feedback with every little tiny assignment. So you do want to pick and choose a little bit, because if you sent out an email, you know, you don't want to be asking for feedback for something like that, right? If you can kind of just figure things out on your own. And the second thing is that if you are given feedback, you do want to push a little bit. If let's say you've only been given positive feedback, you do want to push a little bit and see if there's anything more that you can improve upon. Constructive criticism may not be easy to take, but it really shows that you're focused on improving and learning. And at the end of the day, that's really what an internship is all about, right? We don't expect interns to be perfect. And that's also something that you should keep in mind. You don't need to be perfect with every little assignment that you take on. You know, just like in movies and books where the main character has a ton of flaws, makes a lot of mistakes, but eventually is able to reach some kind of good, happy ending, that's basically the kind of mentality that you should have as well. With your summer internship, you should allow yourself to make a few mistakes. Prevent them if you can, of course, but always work on improving and getting better. And, you know, at the end of the day, when we were looking at interns and how they performed, that would also be a huge part of whether or not they should get a return offer. You know, it's not about, was this intern perfect throughout the whole experience, but when they were given feedback, were they really receptive to it? And did they improve a lot during their entire internship? So with each important milestone of whatever project you're working on, or after you complete a major assignment, I do recommend trying to get feedback in person if you can, or either through a Zoom call rather than getting it via email. And obviously just being able to talk through something with a person and also expressing what you found challenging and how you think you could improve, communicating all of that while also receiving some positive feedback and constructive criticism. All of this will be looked on very favorably during your mid-internship review or end of the internship review. Tip number 6 is to constantly be taking down notes. This might sound also a little bit of like common advice, but you'd be surprised that a lot of interns actually don't do this. First of all, if it's an audio conference call or a Zoom call, you should be typing up notes and sending it out to your team afterwards, even if they don't ask you to. And first of all, it's obviously just helpful for yourself because then you can help remember everything. But then second of all, no one is going to, you know, say to you, hey, why'd you take notes during this meeting, right? Like, everyone's gonna appreciate it. It's just small little thing that you can do to help out your team. And eventually these small little things over time, as you keep doing it over and over again, will help you seem like someone who's really on the ball and someone that is really willing to go that little bit of extra effort to help out the team. Second, if you're doing an internship, what this means is that you should always, always, always be carrying around a notebook and pen. I always did so during my meetings at JP Morgan, and you just never really know whenever something important is going to come up during a conversation or a meeting. And you also don't know when you're going to randomly be giving out assignments. And so always carry around that notebook and pen. Tip number 7 is to take your work seriously, but not yourself too seriously. Honestly, this is really just my way of saying have a really good attitude at work and be personable. And I think that if you're able to do this, then you're probably gonna increase your chances of getting that return offer by something like 50 to 80%. Basically, if people like you at the office, then you're most likely gonna get that return offer. Now, of course, your work product is super, super important, and whatever you're doing during your job, That really might supersede everything else, but I have seen interns in the past at JP Morgan where their work was really, really solid, but because the team didn't really like them for whatever reason, there was maybe not a good culture fit, they didn't get that return offer. So with that said, what I think is really important is striking a really healthy balance of taking your work really seriously, doing a really good job with whatever assignment you're given, but at the same time, not taking yourself too seriously, meaning that you're able to focus on being a personable person. Because, you know, really at the end of the day, what we're really looking for in a summer intern is, can I see this person as a full-time employee? Would I want to work with this person on the projects that I'm working on? And all of that is really focused on you not being a person who only just focuses only on work and doesn't care at all about colleagues or going to happy hours and getting to know people. All of that stuff is really, really important, and you striking that balance between your work and your personal kind of qualities that you can showcase during your job, both of those are very, very important. Now, I know loosening up in a work environment, especially in a summer internship where you don't really know everyone and so many eyeballs are on your work and there's a lot of pressure of how, you know, you wanting to get that return offer. And so I kind of have two tips for you. The first one is what I mentioned earlier about right away trying to establish relationships with your teammates by setting up those coffee chats in the first 1 to 2 weeks. And that way, you know, in a one-on-one conversation, it's a lot less intimidating and getting to know people in general. And so that's the first thing I'd really, really recommend. The second thing I'd recommend is actually making sure that you really do become a really reliable intern. Do focus on the quality of your work rather than the speed, like I mentioned. And if you're able to basically establish a strong reputation in the first few weeks or half of your internship, then you actually do build a lot of confidence as kind of just a person and professional in general in that work environment. And so then you're able to kind of loosen up. So these two things kind of feed on each other. So I know it may sound a little bit contradictory, but you know, if you're not the most social person, basically what I'm trying to say is do try to make your work product as solid as possible, and that can lead to more confidence later on. If you're just a super, super social person and you are just good in any kind of work environment, then you know, go do your thing and I'm sure you'll be able to get people to like you. And of course, I think you'll realize that that's important in a work setting. Now, before I let you go, I did want to let you know about a promotion that Moomoo, which is a trading app, is doing. If you sign up using my link in the description below, you can get up to 4 free stocks and an Apple stock if you refer 2 friends. And you can also get free Bitcoin if you sign up using my links for Coinbase, Gemini, and other exchanges in my description below. So feel free to check those out if you're interested. Also, as I've stated in my previous videos, I give away $10 to the first commenter and a random comment. So here are our winners today. If that's you, just message me on Instagram. And I'm also giving away 5% of my June 2021 YouTube earnings, and also another 5% away as a small little scholarship for high school students and college students. So check those out again in my description down below if you're interested. All right, with that said, that wraps up the video. If you have any more questions about internships in general or anything, I try to respond to as many comments as I can. So ask away in the comments down below. Thanks so much as always for tuning in. Hope to catch you in the next one. Thanks and peace out.